First of all, I want to start this interview with a very important question. Would you say hi to my grandma out there?
Hi, Grandma Pataki. How are you? Aren't you proud?
Second, would you wish Alyssa a happy birthday? It's her birthday today. She turned 24.
Where's Alyssa? Alyssa, happy birthday. 24, really? My communications director just turned 24. Less than half my age. I know. It's a terrible thing.
Way to make her feel like her career ambitions haven't been fulfilled yet. So,
it doesn't pay that well. She works for me. I'm a really bad guy to work for. You wouldn't want the job. You're way overqualified.
So, you ride your bike around town a lot, and you take the bus a lot. Is it gotten so bad that even you can't find parking downtown?
Yeah, it's gotten to that point.
In your 6 years as mayor, what are some of the achievements you're most proud of?
Well, my number one achievement, the thing I'm most proud of, is being on the Dan Patanky show. Also, the smoking ban was pretty cool.
You know, if it wasn't for that, my grandma would be the furthest back we could see in a place like this. I remember when you would go into the dice and it would be like a London fog. Now, considering that the recession has packed the entire country, including Madison, why do you think Madison has still remained relatively prosperous? You know,
like... There's one primary reason for that. It's all the people coming and spending money here at the Dan Patanky show. So I think that's pretty much it. No, it's, you know, the university is a big part of that, and state government. Well, there's less of state government all the time, unfortunately.
You know, you can at least give yourself a little props for city services. Come on!
I can do what?
Give yourself a little props!
Okay, I am the greatest mayor of Madison.
Yeah!
See, now I gotta give each of you $5 on my way out.
Now, see, Casey drove up here from Chicago. He was one of the people who sent emails. And in the last 3 days, how much money do you think you spent at area taverns?
Quite a few dollars,
Dan. So he's bringing money into the economy because you came on here today.
Thank you. We can use every little bit. Thank you.
Now, why is the city still good for, like, job seekers?
Why is it so good for job seekers?
Yeah. I have friends who are now moving to town who never went to college here because this was, like, one of the only places they could find work.
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, I think the university's got a lot to do with that. The high-tech industries. You know, we got an unemployment rate of 5%, which isn't good, but it's about half of the rate of the rest of the country.
So, I hate to keep on harping on this, but it's a sign of the time. What are some of the challenges, like, budgeting during this recession, trying to keep the balance of keeping services good? Wow. I don't know why I'm asking this question. But what are some of the, like, just sort of challenges of budgeting during a recession?
Well, obviously I think the biggest thing is making sure that, you know, I've got a few bucks left over so I can buy a beer here at the Dan Patanky show. It's the main thing I'm interested in. It's like everybody else. You've got to cut back a little bit and try to make sure that the basic services are maintained. But frankly, I don't know how we're going to get through this budget. I mean, we're looking at a budget deficit next year of like $10 to $15 million, so... I'm going to ask Bridget on the council. Bridget, figure it out, will you? And then I'm golfing Friday, and I got a couple things Saturday, Sunday. Monday morning, if you could have some answers for me, I'd really appreciate it. I got this show I got to do, so thanks.
I'll pencil you in.
You are much better at this than I am. But you should seriously consider doing this once a week. And I think I told you, to give up the mayoring thing.
Yeah. Well, you'd be surprised how many people are urging me to do just that.
Nice! goals ahead for 2009-2010?
Obviously, 2010, once again, appear at the Dan Patanky Show. That's got to be number one.
It's not Dan Patanky, it's Dan Patanky. You know, it's a little annoying when somebody mispronounces your last name.
I wouldn't know. That's never happened. Now, it's not as great as, you know, being on the David Letterman show or Jay Fennell, but still, it's pretty good.
Now, you've been on Fox News. Who's a tougher interviewer?
Oh, God.
Me or them?
Bill O'Reilly? I'd say you, much tougher. For one thing, you know a thing or two. You know, so. It's not like you just make stuff up like Fox News.
I actually do research when I'm at the public library. Now, you've organized something called the New Cities Project. And that's where you get a bunch of mayors from different, like, cities all together. Is that really just so you can brag about Madison?
No, actually, it's a spin-off. The U.S. Conference of Mayors is a big organization, like, you know, 600, 700 cities. And I went to the first one, and all the mayors were slapping each other on the back and drinking cocktails and saying, you're great. And I got a little tired of that, so I formed this group of sort of nerdy policy wonky mayors. We're sort of like, you know, like mayors who didn't get invited to the prom. And, you know, we sit around and talk about tax on incremental financing and stuff like that, and then go home after a couple of days. So,
you don't stay at the conference indefinitely.
Nope. Go home.
So,
for a better one.
It doesn't seem like it considering this weekend, but summer is right around the corner. What are some of your favorite Madison summer activities?
You know, that's sort of typical Madison stuff. I like to bike. I run a little bit. I'm going to try. Who's running the Madison Marathon? Anybody running the Madison Marathon? Oh, come on. Somebody's got to be running the Madison.
These are people who are on their fourth race at 7:20.
That's, we call that protein loading. So I'm going to try to run the Madison half marathon, just a half marathon.
Yeah, oh, only a half marathon, Mayor Dave.
Oh, you'd be surprised. This is a city of, like, iron people, you know, the whole Ironman thing. So in most crowds, when I say, oh, I'm running the half marathon, it's kind of like, oh, so you're riding a bike with training wheels. Oh, big deal, you know. So I'm really impressed that you're impressed.
I was trying to have a 0.5K fun run, but nobody ended up signing up for it, and then it cost me a few thousand dollars. Now, you like to play Sheep's Head on the terrace.
Yes.
What is it about Sheep's Head that you like, and how did you learn it?
Well, first of all, does everybody know what Sheep's Head is? It's a German card game. How many people play Sheep's Head? Oh, good. All right, so we got a little culture here. Good. Now, it's kind of like euchre. How many people play euchre? See, euchre is a perfectly acceptable game for those who can't handle the intellectual challenge of Sheep's Head. But the rules of Sheep's Head make no sense unless you've had, you know, a fermented malt beverage or two. And so you got to learn, that's the other thing, you got to learn as a kid. You cannot learn Sheep's Head as an adult. It's not possible. Because you keep asking questions like, why is that? And there's no answer in Sheep's Head. So, so I play Sheep's Head about once a month at the Moore.
Now, one real final question, probably the most important. Can you teach me how to say your last name?
Well, that's a long story, actually. It's an Irish name. It's actually O. Chislevich, but it got shortened in one of those Ellis Island deals. So, O. Chislevich. Or Dave. Dave is good.
Dave Cheslevich.
Yes.